Games have provided people with enjoyment and fun for many, many years. The first video game came to be in October of 1958 when physicist William H. created a legendary game that would bring forth innovation for years to come. That's right, Pong. This was a simple but fun game that you could play with your friends, or I guess I should say friend, and have an absolute blast. However, even before then, humans were finding ways to enjoy themselves through forms of friendly competition. In fact, over 5,000 years ago, five big ones, the Babylonians were getting lit playing this game. They were listening to NBA Youngboy sipping gallons of creatine whilst listening to a game called the Royal Game of Ur. Though this important discovery was made back in 3000 BC, I like to think that the most marvelous, the most memorable, the Jesus of all games that has come to be, way back in 2009, Minecraft. Hello everybody, my name is Manus, and today I would like to embark on a journey with you guys in discussing how Minecraft has single-handedly changed gaming for me, for you, and for everyone, forever. I remember when good old prepubescent Manus went over to a friend's house for a sleepover. It was on that very sleepover that I was graced with the knowledge of this simple and enjoyable game. I spent more time that night glued to the computer screen playing Minecraft than actually interacting with my friend. I loved the game so very much that the very first thing that I did when I got home the next morning was literally beg my mom and dad to grace me with the permission to download the game on their MacBook. Now, this was no easy feat. You see, here's the thing about my parents. They were never really into letting us or any of my siblings play video games, like, at all. And, like, literally the only console that any of us ever got was the Nintendo Wii that we got 11 years. So, like, literally in 2010, that's when we got it. We got it in 2010. So, being able to try to convince my mom and dad to let me get this computer game, like, it was a task that was literally impossible. However, against all odds, somehow I ended up convincing my parents to let me download Minecraft Java Edition on that MacBook. And oh boy, I spent every waking moment of free time I had just experimenting and having fun in the game. I play on super flat worlds, literally just commit mass arson to every village. I would think I was super good and go into creative mode and then go beat the Ender Dragon in creative mode. And although my ways of playing the game were definitely not very noble, I was still obsessed with it. And it was and still is my favorite game, and it probably always will be. Now, the purpose of this video is not just to talk about how awesome Minecraft is, although I would love to do that, and I could probably just go on for hours, because I definitely have. I don't want to focus on that. I feel like too many people focus on that. So what I'm going to be focusing on today is how Minecraft, like, literally just changed it, like, just changed the prospect and how it influenced other games with, like, you'll see. Because of Minecraft's amazing simplicity, millions of little kids, including me, figured out how to play the game using a mouse and keyboard. Something that, like, to me when I was a little kid seemed so complicated. It had like 50 options. Like, that was crazy to me. Like, coming from the Wii, like, where we only had like 6 different buttons that we could press. Sometimes we could shake it and it would do something cool, but like, that was it, you know? So, like, that was crazy to me. However, because of Minecraft's amazing simplicity, it taught me and millions of other little kids how to use the keyboard to our advantage. And being able to figure out this strangely complicated controller gave us the amazing skill set to be able to just jump into other games like Valorant and Fortnite and all these other games that have come out, like, in recent years after Minecraft has on the computer, of course. It gave us all the general basics, and it created like a whole community of people and of kids that now know how to use these different tools just because of this game, because of how simple it was, and because of just how absolutely awesome it is. Anyways, now I'm going to go back to talking about how cool Minecraft is. Now, Minecraft has changed a lot over the years. And yes, I am only making this video because today is Minecraft's birthday, hopefully. But Minecraft is the only game that has kept me coming back to it for almost 9 years. Like, Dude, I'm a senior in high school. I'm going to be an adult next year, and I feel like I've changed so much from how I was when I first discovered my favorite game. I'm taller, I'm smarter, I'm faster, I'm weaker, not much bigger, less confident. But now, instead of only being able to game on a crappy MacBook, I now have an entire gaming station that I spent years working for that I can literally get like 1,000 FPS just in Minecraft on. But there are a few things that haven't changed, and that, of course, is my inability to converse with the female species. And also my love for Minecraft. This game has gotten me and thousands of other individuals through rough times. Just last year, my family moved across the country. I had no friends and no way to make them because of, you know, the global pandemic that was literally at full force at that time. It was honestly one of the hardest times of my life. I was sad, I was depressed, I felt alone, and like nobody really cared. But one thing seemed to continually bring me joy. One thing seemed to pull me out of the dumps when I needed it most. And that, of course, was my love for our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ, baby. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. And that thing was, of course, Minecraft. In fact, it was during that time that I fell in love with video editing and content creation. And it was also through Minecraft that I met some absolutely awesome people who I had consider to be some of my closest and best friends. Thanks to Minecraft, we have all been able to see and understand what it means and how it feels to truly enjoy a game. The game set the bar so high for other video games and has brought means for other games to be so successful and enjoyable. Although it is by no means the first video game that has been around, it is in no doubt the best one. Happy birthday, Minecraft. You deserve it.